Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, it is a great honor and a pleasure for me to address you today at the opening of your important conference. I deeply regret that due to the Corona travel restrictions, I was not able to come to Bulgaria and to join you. Bulgaria is a country that is very close to my heart, and I have many friends in your country. I hope that everybody is well. At the same time, I hope that our European Union will show sufficient strength and solidarity to demonstrate how important European integration, especially in periods of crisis and hardship, is. Let me begin by saying that I welcome very much the decision to organize a conference in memory of the 15th anniversary of the signing of the accession treaty of Bulgaria. That is indeed a country, that is indeed a date worth to remember, because it is a date that changed the history not only of Bulgaria, it changed the history of the whole European Union. For most of the people in the European Union today, and probably also for most of the people in your own country, the membership of Bulgaria in the European Union is self-evident. It's a matter of life, a fact of life. But we should never forget that it was difficult to achieve. The EU membership of Bulgaria did not fall like manna from heaven. It was the result of tough political decisions. And I have to say that the most important contribution came from the Bulgarian society itself. At the end of the day, it's always the people who have to shoulder the burden of transformation. How far this transformation of the political, economic, and social system of Bulgaria went is generally undervalued and underestimated in the so-called old member states. I want to make that absolutely clear. The accession of Bulgaria was based on true merits and nothing else. Bulgaria was sufficiently prepared. The rules and institutions were in place. I remember very well the fact that strong doubts remained in EU institutions and in member states. And that is the reason why a so-called safeguard mechanism was included in the accession treaty. It's important to underline that this clause was never enforced because there was no need to do it. The same doubts were already present when the whole process of the Eastern enlargement of the European Union started. As you remember, Bulgaria did not belong to the first group of countries to begin the negotiations. There were doubts whether Bulgaria was sufficiently prepared to meet the conditions for membership. The new EU Commission under President Romani Prodi in 1999 drew different conclusions. The Prodi Commission said that it was probably more promising to organize a well-structured process with a lot of clear target dates, with permanent review of progress and strong assistance from member states, EU institutions, and from private organizations, from NGOs. And history tells us that the assessment of the Prodi Commission was right. We should not forget the year 1999, in which this decision was made, was a year in which the true spirit of European integration, the true sense of the whole project was more visible to politicians and people than it might be today. 1999 was the year of the Kosovo War, and the idea of European integration as a peace project was seen as a strong political commitment. The commitment was to bring to an end the terrible Balkan Wars, and everybody accepted the notion that that was not achievable without support of Bulgaria, and that for that we needed a truly democratic, stable, and reliable Bulgaria. I have a lot of memories as far as the negotiations are concerned, because I was the commissioner in charge. I do fully recognize the merits of the Bulgarian government that was in place when I started in 1999. I remember the important contributions of Nadezhda Mikhailova, but I have to say that the real breakthrough came when the government of the former king, Simeon, won the election and took over. That was a government that was strongly committed, had a very clear strategy, and I can tell you, it was second to none as far as true European spirit was concerned. I could mention a lot of names here, but I will restrict myself to just three of them, who are my good friends, and their contribution should not be forgotten. It's Simeon Sachs-Kobogotsky himself as the Prime Minister, Solomon Passy, Minister for Foreign Affairs, and Magdalena Kuniva, the Minister for European Integration, who later became my estimated colleague in the European Commission. Now, 15 years after the event, we can clearly see that the enlargement process was a full success. Not everybody in the European Union knows that, and not everybody acknowledges it. The reason why enlargement is not high on the agenda, on the contrary, it is not very popular. The reason is simply that policymakers do not communicate sufficiently the success of the Eastern enlargement. Therefore, I want to state it in very clear terms. Despite all the problems, despite the crisis which we had 10 years ago, but for which Bulgaria and Romania and other countries were not responsible, despite that, the membership of Bulgaria in the European Union is a full success, and you can be proud that you have achieved it. I thank you very much for your attention. I wish you all the best. Stay healthy, and I hope that very soon we can meet again in your wonderful capital, Sofia.